Итак, дамы и господа, мы продолжаем наше соревнование. Разрешена разминка третьей группы участников. Итак, представляем третью группу. Константин Меньшов, город Санкт-Петербург. Гордей Горшков, город Санкт-Петербург. Михаил Коляда, город Санкт-Петербург. Адьян Питкеев, город Москва. Александр Петров, город Санкт-Петербург. И Максим Ковтун, Москва, Екатеринбург. Дамы и господа, представляем партнеров чемпионата России по фигурному катанию. Компания «Ника» – ведущий производитель ювелирных часов в России. Компания «Борг» – надежная бытовая техника премиум-класса. Официальный спонсор чемпионата «Чай ТЭС». Коллекция ТЭС – это
великолепная сорта черного ледяного
Break is always shorter than expected.
Yeah.
We had to rush back. Yeah, I went to the mix zone just to had a look to pick up some comments from Sergei Voronov. And he said that he is happy that he was able to fight to the end, that he didn't give up. It was his 12th Russian nationals, imagine.
12th Russian nationals?
Yeah, yes.
Wow.
He said that, and that only one time before he felt like in such a bad situation after the short. 1 year when he was also outside, well, he was inside the top 10 now, but so, and he's still undecided about his future. He will think about his future after this,
yeah.
Analyze everything what happened and then make a decision. And now it's the last group on the ice, and I guess well, pretty sure in this group it will be decided who is going to be 2016 Russian national champion in the men's, and who are the medal winners, and who is going to the European championships. And this is the first final result. And this Alexander Gorshkov, president of the Russian Figure Skating Federation, said at the press conference, on the opening press conference, that number one and number two are, they are secured their spot on the national team for Europeans. And then about the third place, there will be a decision taken by the coaches' council that will meet on Sunday. And just to remind, we have in the lead after the short program is Maxim Kovtun. Also, he missed the triple axel, but he landed two quads. And second, surprisingly, newcomer Michail Kalyada. And in third, Adrian Pitkiev, another very talented young skater. He was in third last year. Maxim is the defending champion. Well, he was just on the screen.
And last of the Mohican, Konstantin Menshov.
Yes, Konstantin, another sentimental favorite.
Another dinosaur in the figure skating of Russia.
Has been around for so, so many years. So if Sergei says it was his 12th national, so it must be like his 15th national.
Yeah, we can definitely ask. Elena Buyanova Vodorezova, who is coaching Maxim Kovtun. Maxim is from this city, from this town. This is his home. And definitely he will have crowd, he will have crowd help during his performance.
Yeah, but yesterday he said that he was really nervous and he almost fainted after his performance. There was so much pressure on him and he felt really sick after his program and had a headache and he couldn't even go to the mix zone right after. But he was there for the press conference. He was recovered by then. Mm-hmm. But Maxim, yeah, he's like, he's talented, but he's a bit of a head case sometimes.
Yeah.
Okay.
We'll start
now
with
Konstantin. Konstantin Menshov.
Russian quad performer. He performs quad tour for more than already a decade.
Konstantin Menshov, город Санкт-Петербург.
And Konstantin, he unfortunately injured his shoulder again in the training here. See, he was still touching his shoulder. So he was affected by that. And yesterday, he missed the triple axel, the bad fall of the triple axel.
Also a very experienced competitor. He's been at Europeans, at World Championships. He's done so many competitions.
So let's hope he skates well.
Spot. unfortunately, another mistake on landing. With quadruple toes, double toe combination. Triple axle now. Another double axle. Catch second foot on the ice.
His shoulder is bothering him, so I think he just he fought for it, and respect to him that he did not withdraw, that he decided to stay in, to go out and compete, maybe also one last time, who knows.
Yeah, he's a true competitor, also absolutely big respect to what he did and what he does on the ice. We can see he's struggling. And sport is always comes with injuries. I mean, some people have many, some people have less, but all of them they injured. That's come, we call that comes with the package. It's impossible to not to be injured when you are going in the very, very high quality technical performances.
Yeah, so Konstantin, he has had his share of injuries. Remember that terrible fall and the triple axel and the World Team Trophy.
Dislocated the shoulder.
Yeah, 3 years ago, and then he had to withdraw then. And in the short pro, the free skating, sorry, he skated a great short, and then he had that bad fall in the free, and he couldn't continue, couldn't finish the performance, and he had surgery after that. And then he was thinking what to do. I'm waking up to ash and dust. Decided to continue and still had some good competitions. Yeah, that was it. Watched second triple axel. And this year he won Finlandia Trophy, and he was on the podium at Nebelhorn Trophy, and also at the Grand Prix, not far away from the podium. But yeah, it's sad. It's if you have an injury and then you cannot give 100%.
Yes, so far he's on third place with
276,
233.76.
So behind Voronov and Aliyev. Gardy Gershkov, St. Petersburg, another Rukavitsyn student. That's why Yevgeny Rukavitsyn was not with Konstantin now in the Kiss and Cry. And
son of two skaters.
Yes.
Father and mother.
I talked about that yesterday also. He's yeah, well, let's see what he does first.
He will try to do a quadruple loop. Double toe. like his costume. It's very elegant.
On that second triple axel, I really like the overall quality of his skating. Nice spins.
Great spins. Finally, I can see steady, beautiful camel position.
Yes.
And spin position.
Yes.
Honestly, I cannot look anymore on those when spins are, you know, like all these weird positions. Nobody delivers such a beautiful lines, such a great quality of spins. That's really missing. That's what I really would like to see.
Yeah, it's true that it's not often these days that you see somebody doing these clean, pure positions.
Pure positions. It's not that many people can do it, pure, beautiful positions. Like Robin Cousins used to do camel spin or sit spin. Robert Wagenhofer, also great positions. Todd Eldridge, beautiful sit spin. And of course, Stéphane Lamiel.
Yeah, so he did not go for his quad loop, so he doesn't have a quad that's consistent yet. It took him long to learn the triple axel, so these days usually it works. So he landed one in the program. And he was, I said that yesterday already, he was fifth last year's national. It's a great result for him. And he was in fourth after the short program. He has a good chance to retain that position.
He even without quad and only with one triple axel, he will get a big score because of good quality of skating and really nice spins.
I remember from his junior days. Anyway, so 164. So he's in first place overall and in the long program as well.
So Gordey Gorshkov already overtake Sergei Voronov.
Well, he was ahead of him anyway, but he will be, with four skaters to come, he will be in the top five. That means he is again a national team member, and he will be in the exhibition gala. So now it's Mikhail Kalyada. And I'm really a fan of this guy. I really like his explosive jumps, and his interesting choreography, interesting way to move. And he's become much more consistent since his injury.
Beautiful quadruple toe. Martinez, sorry. Jump. Jump.
fast. That was, well, I'm a fan officially.
Well done.
Yeah, Michael Kalyada.
Michael Kalyada.
This morning in practice, after this, in the morning practice, I thought he might win today. And, well, there's still skaters to come, but he will be on the podium today. A strong comeback after being out with injury last year. I was just saying, it's a really strong comeback from Michael after being out with injury last year. And just think, like the effortlessness of his jumps, the height, explosiveness, out of nowhere, not like setting up forever for
correct.
His jumps.
Exactly.
And then I remember at the Grand Prix in Moscow, one of that's the quarto we're going to see now. A cameraman, one of my friends, a cameraman, he said he had trouble catching Kalyada because he suddenly jumped and jumped so high. And I told Michael that, and he laughed and he said that, well, he thinks it's by nature that he can jump so high, but his coach taught him a very good technique.
Coached by Valentina Chebotaryova, her brother Alexander Smagin lives for more than 22 years in the state of Louisiana, former skater, I think he works in a hotel now. We used to skate together in the show. That's the coach's brother.
Yeah, Michael has been with his coach from the very beginning, he said, and she's not the famous coach.
Yes.
So she's the first top-level skater. He is the first top-level skater she has, but obviously he was also asked in Ross Telecom if he's considering to change coaches, to go to a more famous coach, and he said, no, I'm going to stick with my coach. So that's the lead for now, 170.18 in the three.
That's a great score.
267.3. So, as I said, he will be on the podium.
He will be on the podium.
And
he will.
In the morning practice, I even felt like he could win today. But I didn't want to say anything. I didn't want to jinx it. Now I can say it. He skated. But now it's Adrian Pitkeev. Another very, very talented young skater. Great qualities. Unfortunately, a little injured, so he's not at the top of his game. Has back problems for 2 weeks. That affected him, especially in the triple axel.
Famous music, Mission by Ennio Morricone. Starting out with quad. Actually, he was surprised with that fall. Unexpected. Now another quad.
Yeah, he pops. I think he. That wasn't good for his back, this fall.
Thank you. definitely not his day today.
He's in pain. It's really sad to see. But a shame, because I also think he is has a great future.
You know, these days, trying to do with all these quads and trying to be on the top level, it's so difficult on the body. Everybody get injured. All of those skaters, they get injured. It's so difficult. And sometimes the pain can be so strong that your body cannot even do anything during the jump. So good for him. Even being injured, he goes and he delivers at least.
But he tried. Yeah. He tried. He did not give up. But sometimes you make it worse. I don't know. And I saw it after the Ross Telecom Cup, he could win nationals because he was really going strong. And that was his terrible fall.
Being right here. He his back also a little bit.
Yeah. Choreographer can't even look at that. Yeah, so I think he was going to win nationals. But now, of course, major setback because of the injury.
Yeah.
Just couldn't do more.
He will be behind Gorshkov.
He will drop.
Still shows good flexibility.
Ah, that must hurt too on his back. That was a double axle, double toe, double loop combination towards the end. Yeah, but hopefully he will heal up and then he can come back very strong, because he has this lightness on his feet, also very nice and light jumps. It's getting more and more expressive too, needs to learn a little bit more to look at the audience, to play with the audience. He's still a little shy on the ice.
43.86.
Yeah, that's 7th place only. Yes, with
23 overall, 20.49, only 7th place behind
Menchov.
And now it's Alexander Petrov, another young skater from St. Petersburg. Years old. I said yesterday he could have stayed in juniors, but decided to move up to the senior level for the Grand Prix. And now, well, he was at senior nationals already last year. 5th place after the short, and he still can pull up.
And he doesn't have quad jump yet.
He will, like Gardy Gashkov, he will go for a clean program with triples.
Triple axel, double toe. We'll be right back. microphone.
So,
and he scores really good.
I think he will be in second now after Kalyada.
Yes.
So he will move up. And he will be on the podium because there's only one more skater to come. He even has the highest technical score. I think
Alexander Petrov.
He's still a bit plain, let's say, like that way, you know. I don't mean that in a bad way. Yes, still very young and not as expressive, maybe, as older. And
very quiet, kind of emotionally. I mean, he...
Well, no, but ice, in the show, I mean, he skates in galas, he's very different.
He gets crazy. I mean, he's really close, like, inside, like, you know, he doesn't express his feelings except when he's performing. You know, he's a very quiet person. Off the ice.
But he has definitely progressed since last year.
You know, he's always consistent. The only problem that he doesn't have a quad.
Yeah, he tried in practice this morning, but it didn't work.
Yeah, he's trying very hard. I mean, I see him at practice. I attempt practices in St. Petersburg quite often, and I see how hard he tries, but so far, it's not there yet.
For my taste, a bit too focused on the execution of the jumps in his program. It's really so going, you can see he's setting up for jump.
Yeah.
He goes for the jump. But
that's Mishin's way.
Yes.
He puts the jumps always ahead of everything.
But there will be a reward for this here. There's a medal at Russian National.
Looks
senior.
Like he will medal. According to technical score, what we see, he will overtake Gorshkov, who is right now on second position.
And his technical score was even higher than Kalyada's.
Yes.
Because the jumps were clean, well done. Probably got high levels on his spins too. Very accurate performance.
Yeah. Absolutely clean program.
Wait for the score. And Maxim Koptun is on the ice.
Yeah,
the last to skate. And okay, so 167. Yeah, but I think that's right.
He got the deduction because of what probably hit it.
Time.
Yes.
But I think he is happy because he knows he has a medal. And I think, yeah, second, I would have had him second too. And now Maxim Koftun, home crowd skater. And he's very sensitive to pressure. And he has to skate last. So I hope that doesn't affect him too much.
Maxim
Because for Maxim, you don't know what to expect. He can be good and he can be terrible. Yeah, and he said yesterday he didn't want to disappoint the crowd. after after a pumping her fist.
She is. She's sitting next to us. So dramatic. By Peter Chernyshov.
I did really think he would not last, but he did. Good for him. He was, and there's Tarasova, very excited. And Maxim gets very emotional. It means a lot to him. As I said before, he is sensitive to pressure. And there was a lot of pressure on him. He can't hold back the tears.
Yes, today, local skaters, they deliver the best performance.
Well, I'm
first Yulia Lipnitskaya, and now Maxim Kovtun. Crowd must be very happy and pleased with their home favor, skaters.
Yeah, that's nice to see that Maxim was able to hold it together. And his fan tribune.
That's his girlfriend.
So we have Maxim Kovtun, and then two new faces on the podium.
Yep.
Mikhail Kalyada and
Alexander Petrov.
Adjan, unfortunately, injured. Foul away from the podium this time. Sergey Voronov moved up. Yeah, Maxim, he fought for it.
Yeah. That was a nice one.
At the beginning by himself, because the free dance is coming up. But I must say, Ari, I really appreciate Peter Chernyshov's choreography, but I don't really get that program.
This one?
Yes.
Peter is an artist.
Человек, да. А то все, знаешь, делай вот эту ёбочку. Ничего поменялось.